Skinny cat, why is my cat always hungry? Why is my cat eating but losing weight? These are some of the questions you might have, and you're in the right place. In this video today, we will cover the main causes of weight loss in cats, how veterinarians identify the cause, what the treatments are, and if you're staying till the end, we'll discuss a simple free test that you can use at home, which won't cost you anything, and will help you monitor your cat's health and alert you to when you need to see your veterinarian. Welcome to Dr. Pawfection. My name's Jason. I'm a small animal veterinarian for the last 19 years. Let's get into the video. So the main causes in cats for losing weight are either not eating enough calories or losing too many calories. Not eating enough calories is a simple fix. We just increase how much food they eat. Now, for a cat that's losing weight but eating as much, if not more than normal, the three main causes are renal disease, that is kidney disease, diabetes, which is the cat's inability to control its sugar levels in its bloodstream, and an overactive thyroid known as hyperthyroidism. Now, as cat owners or guardians, what we would see at home in all three of those cases is an increase in eating or appetite, wanting food more often or wanting more food. So in renal disease, and in diabetes, the other symptom owners will notice is an increase in thirst and subsequently going to the toilet to urinate a lot more often. The other cause in an older cat for losing weight, sometimes you could have what they call small cell lymphoma in the intestines. So, how do the veterinarians diagnose this? Well, what we need to do is take your cat to the vet. The veterinarians will need to perform some blood tests to measure blood glucose levels, to assess chemicals that indicate function of the kidneys, and also measure thyroid hormone or T4 levels in the cat. Now, they'll usually probably want to get a urine sample to assess whether the kidneys have the ability to concentrate urine and also whether there's too much sugar in the urine. If the kidneys are working normally, they shouldn't be letting any sugar out unless the cat's diabetic. In a hyperthyroid cat, what you'll see is a cat that wants to eat more food or more often, maybe vomiting or having diarrhea at times, and their coat will look dull or unkempt is what it's sometimes described as. And you start to feel their ribs more easily. They're feeling more skinny. Now, the textbooks do say that hyperthyroid cats may also be drinking more as well. In my clinical experience, and with three of my cats which all had hyperthyroidism, I haven't seen that to be the case. Certainly they eat more, but I haven't noticed increased thirst. In a diabetic cat, what you'll see is a cat who wants to eat more food, they're drinking more, and they're urinating more, and yet they're still losing weight. In a kidney disease cat, similar symptoms, they're eating more, they're drinking more, but they're still losing weight. Now, once the veterinarians have got a diagnosis, which is based on clinical history of what the owners have seen at home and the blood results, in hyperthyroid cats, the options are to put them on tablets or liquid, which will block the effect of the thyroid hormone. Other options, rarely these days, but sometimes surgery may be recommended depending on what type of thyroid tumor it is. Now, when we say thyroid tumor, there are benign tumors and there are malignant tumors. So benign tumors just grow where they are and they don't spread elsewhere. Malignant tumors can actually spread elsewhere in the body. So the other treatment option in a hyperthyroid cat is radioactive iodine treatment. And that's where veterinarians trained in this treatment will give your cat a dose of radioactive iodine, and then they'll need to be kept in a special hospital for about 8 days because the radiation levels being emitted from your cat is too high for it to be safe to be at home with yourself. And usually the veterinarians and the nursing staff can only be in that room for about 15 minutes a day. Iodine is part of the thyroid hormone, and iodine in the body of a cat or a human or dog for that matter is concentrated in the thyroid gland. So radioactive iodine therapy targets the thyroid gland itself. The half-life of radioactive iodine is 8 days. So what that means is if I give a cat 1 gram of radioactive iodine, in 8 days' time, there is only half a gram of radioactive iodine. And then in another 8 days, there is now only 1/4 of a gram of radioactive iodine. So usually these cats are kept in hospital in a special facility for about 8 days, and then they're sent home with instructions on how the owners are to handle disposing of urine and feces from the cat until the radioactive levels have dropped to a level that's no longer of concern. There are also limits at times on how close the cat can sit on you. You know, you'd need to talk to the veterinarians who practice radioactive iodine therapy, but it is the one treatment that the medicine specialists say may actually cure rather than control your cat's hyperthyroidism. So if your veterinarians come back to you and said that your cat's diabetic, then your cat needs to be treated with insulin. There are various different types of insulin, and your veterinarian will pick one that's suitable for your cat. And then it involves yourself or someone at home giving an injection of insulin every 12 hours usually, but your veterinarian can go through that with you. Often they will probably want to give the first dose and keep the cat in hospital for 8 to 12 hours. And they'll probably take a number of blood samples, usually every 1 to 2 hours, to measure the glucose level in your cat's bloodstream after the insulin's been given, because they want to see how long until the lowest level of blood glucose is reached. And they'll also want to measure the lowest level the blood glucose gets to. We don't want the blood glucose to get below usually 5 millimoles per litre. And that's the lowest point of the blood glucose level after insulin is called the nadir. Sometimes there'll be gradual dose adjustments every 1 to 3 weeks until the right dose for your cat is found. The needles are very small. It's like a little acupuncture needle, and they're just given under the skin, and the owners can be trained by their veterinarian how to give the injections. In a diabetic cat, they will want to assess the urine and measure whether there's glucose in the urine and also whether there are ketones in the urine. Now, when a cat or a dog or a human's diabetic, if not enough glucose is getting into the cells, the brain can only use glucose or ketones as a fuel source. So the body's metabolism will switch over to metabolizing fat, and ketones are a byproduct of fat metabolism. We do want to see a small amount of glucose in the urine. If we're treating with insulin and we find there's no glucose in the urine, the veterinarians are concerned the cat may be going into remission, which is not a bad thing. That means the cat may no longer need insulin, and sometimes cats can go into remission for diabetes, unlike dogs. Dogs do not go into remission if they're diabetic. But if a cat's gone into remission, then the insulin may need to be stopped, because giving insulin when a cat's no longer diabetic, or if it's in diabetic remission, may cause the sugar levels to go too low and cause a hypoglycemic event, which can be life-threatening. So usually with a diabetic cat, they will want you to measure water intake daily, measure weight regularly, food intake, and usually keep the food consistent in the amount the cat's eating. Now, if your cat has renal disease, then usually the management is dietary modification. There are diets recommended for cats with renal disease which are low in protein. Too much protein in a cat's diet, if the cat has kidney disease or renal disease, can cause more inflammation in the kidneys and increase the rate the disease progresses. Now, sometimes with cats with renal disease, the phosphorus level in the bloodstream may be too high, and sometimes veterinarians may prescribe a phosphate binder. So if also on urine analysis, they find that there's considerable protein in your cat's urine, that is proteins leaking out through the kidneys, they may also treat your cat with an ACE inhibitor. So the simple test that you can perform at home, and it won't cost you anything, but it'll give you valuable insight into how your cat's health is, whether they're diabetic or hyperthyroid or having renal disease, is to weigh your cat. And the simplest way to weigh your cat would be to pick your cat up and hold it and weigh yourself and your cat on your bathroom scales. Then put the cat down, just weigh yourself, subtract your weight from the combined weight of yourself and your cat. That saves you having to try and get your cat to stand still on the scales. And I would do this every 2 weeks to at least every month. As owners or pet guardians, often we don't realize how much weight our cat's losing because we're seeing them every day and they're only losing a little bit every day. And even myself with my own cats, I've been surprised sometimes when I have gone to weigh my cat and found that the weight loss had been maybe more than I'd expected. Now, if there is weight loss continuing, you need to go back to your vet and discuss with them further treatment options or modifying the treatment. Anyway, I hope this helped you. If you found the content useful, please consider sharing with friends and family. It helps the YouTube algorithm know that the content's useful and it will then share it with other people. Our aim at Dr. Pawfection is to educate owners and pet guardians so that they can optimise their pet's health and to learn a bit more about the things to watch out for so that they know when they should go and see their veterinarian. The content in this video is for education and entertainment. It should not replace your own veterinarian's opinion and advice, as they know your pet's medical history. And any specific concerns, please consult with your veterinarian. If you found the content useful or entertaining, please consider pressing the subscribe or like button. It actually does show YouTube's algorithm that the content's useful and worthwhile sharing with other people. And consider sharing with your friends and family if you've got anyone who's got a cat, whether they're unwell at the moment or just so that they know what to watch out for as their cats get older.